Uriel, awaken. Hear me, Uriel. The end of days is upon us. The process is complete. The world will be consumed, and my children will ascend. As it should be. But, Uriel, I have made mistakes. Out of arrogance, out of fear, I sinned against the process. I cast out those who opposed me, imprisoned them in a place beyond this garden. Now they are trapped, and they cannot ascend. All that they are, all that they know, will be lost. But I cannot free them. They are beyond my reach now. What I ask of you, my beloved messenger, is a terrible sacrifice. You must enter this realm of despair. You must free the souls I have imprisoned. Undo my mistake. I have opened a gateway and granted you the gift of time. Uriel, I'm sorry. I wish there was more I could do. Please, save them.
Thank you. battle. Would you like a biscuit? I hate puzzles. I won't harm you. Please come closer. Hey, this looks familiar. Where am I? I must be in wrong game. Hello. Come closer. This looks familiar.
Thank you.
beginning were the words and the word.
Thank you.
In New Jerusalem, there is a temple, and upon its gate is written, "Who dares to judge the dead? For they are nothing. And who dares to judge the living? For they are damned to nothingness. Judge only the city which is eternal. You too must stand before that gate and contemplate the fate of your children. Only then will you understand why you must die. For the city grows only through sacrifice, and each man kills the thing he loves." In a dream, I heard the voice of my friend. Following it, I came upon a golden city in the green and pleasant lands of paradise. I asked, "Where is my friend? For I hear the echo of his voice, but I cannot see him." And the people said, "He is everywhere and nowhere. His bones are the bones of the city, his blood is the blood in our veins. For that is how cities are built, not of brick and mortar, nor of love and hope, Cities are built of sacrifice. In a vision, I saw a prophet, and he said, "There is no heaven, and there is no hell. There is only the earth, and the bones of the dead within." I asked, "How then may we find salvation?" And he said, "You must build a new Jerusalem. Out of the bones of the dead, we built a golden city. But salvation is not immortality. In the end, there is only the earth, and to the earth we all return. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust." heard a voice in the wilderness crying, "Arise, arise, children of the New Jerusalem. Your centuries of struggle are ended. The war is won. Peace is come at last." And all the living came forth and rejoiced at the beauty of the city that was built in a green and pleasant land called Paradise. "Whose hands built this city?" I asked. "The hands of the dead," said the voice. "And where are they that we may thank them for their gift?" Now the voice was silent, and I knew. Though their deeds endure, the dead are gone.